And you're up.
Okay, here we go. What's poppin', Berks? finally, we got something that's going to like take you into your different parts of the county, different parts of the city, and show you what's really poppin'. Let me first start with a little bit about myself and how this came about. I was sitting home, going through the stations, and really couldn't find anything on TV that told me what was going on in my town, you know, in my city, in my county. So what I did was I started to do a little digging and found out that BCTV, you know, gave people like me a chance to be informative through TV about what's popping in Berks County. And it was kind of challenging at first. You have to come and you have to submit and you have to get qualified and, you know, come up with something that's nourishing for everyone. So I thought I could do it, and here we are. So now I'm a barber, you know, as well as a promoter and an event planner. And the two businesses mix pretty good with getting out and getting about in the town. You know, I'm everywhere and I talk to a lot of people. So if there's a person that's qualified to cut your hair or to tell you what's popping, it is I, Gordy. So I want to start to talk about the barber industry in Berks County. It's vast. I've been a lot of places. I've lived in Philly. I spent a lot of time in New York. I'm down Atlanta. I'm in Miami. And I get my hair cut everywhere. And Berks County has a lot of good barbers. I've had terrible haircuts in New York, Miami, and big cities. And then I come here and I get really cool haircuts. And there's so many different kind of barbers. So what I did was I set out over the last couple of days to find the perfect haircut, some of the best barbers. And in a second, I'll show you a video of me out and about in the town, just walking up and into brand new barbershops, old barbershops, and doing what I do. So with that, we'll sit back and we'll take a look at the barbershops that I visit. Berks County, Shemaine here, downtown Gordy Brown. And today we are going to go inside some of the best barbershops in Berks County. We're gonna find out how good these guys really are. Also, we'll explore if you're interested in barbering, I'd obtain a barber license from A to Z. So sit back, enjoy. Come on with me. I'll take you somewhere you've never been. Out by the DMV, and I always drive past this place, and it's called Buzzworthy. Let's go see what's going on in here. I often ride past here, and this is like a nice little shop, and it's called what?
Called Buzzworthy.
And you are?
Tara
Oxenreiter. Okay, and I see you got a nice fade game. So I guess so anybody can come in here and show up and you do walk-ins?
We try to do walk-ins. We mainly do appointments.
Okay, appointments only.
Yes.
And we're right here. This is a nice, safe location.
Right across from Giant.
Right across from Giant. And you're very personal. But well, like I said, my name is Gordy and I will be in to get a cut.
Okay.
And it was nice meeting you.
Yes, nice meeting you too.
And let me go in here and talk to these guys. This is right on Lancaster Avenue 2, up toward the bank in Flanagan's. Hey, what's going on, guys? I was just in the neighborhood, and I said, you know what? I might as well, you know, stop in and see if I can still get that job.
Yeah, you can, whenever you
okay,
want.
Okay, my man. You are?
Manny,
and you are?
Jose.
And you guys been here for about how long?
10 months.
10 months. And they got a nice little thing going here. Safe. Smooth, they're always here, it's reliable. And look at that fade game. That's straight curly hair, and he put a nice fade on that. So, yeah. So that's what's up. So guys, I'm gonna let you know that I will patronize and I will definitely spread the word that this is definitely a place that's on the rise. You guys have a good day.
You too, thank you, good luck.
My man. This is one of my favorite areas, like 8th and Oley. They did a lot of work over here, supermarkets, bakeries, daycare, some of the best tacos out.
Oh, yeah.
But the big thing right here is ATS Barbershop. And this is where I cut
hair before, and this is where I actually get my hair cut at. And these are some great barbers right here. And all my man's over here. Man, he just got his license. Where'd you get your license from?
Reading Barber Institute.
Yeah, he was one of the first. As we make our way up here, we got a bunch of new barbers, a bunch of guys that have been here forever. And my barber right here, he's doing a crazy fade right now. I think, in my opinion, Hefe, the best. However, there's a bunch of barbers in this area. Hey, come on, man, right here, got another barber. But yeah, now this is a Dominican, the foundation over here is Dominican. And these guys are friendly.
African Dominican.
Yes, and they're friendly, and they welcome everybody. You can come walk-ins. You can do appointments. One thing for sure, when you come here, you're going to get a banging haircut.
Welcome back. As you can see, there's several different types of barbershops. So what I did was, after I, visited a couple, I invited a couple barbers to actually come back and sit and talk to us. This gentleman right here came to my attention. You know, he's from ATS, and he was in the paper, and he came to my attention because I remember him when he first got started. And with that, I'd like to introduce my first guest, and you are?
Samuel Pomales.
Okay. And you work where at?
ATS Barbershop.
And like I asked you on the video, you got your license from where?
Reading Barber Institute.
Okay. Now, I remember when I first came in there maybe about 6 months ago. I remember you doing it, you were cutting a little kid. And I remember the instructor, a master barber, Alex. Yeah. Alex runs, along with Serge, they run ATS Barbershop as well as the Institute. Alex taught me how to cut. Alex is basically my barber also. I deal with two barbers. Alex is just so on point and on time. I can get him at 6 o'clock in the morning. And then I have, if I'm just in and out, no schedule, I catch Kaku at the ATS Barbershop. So I'm gonna go back to when you were first cutting, I watched how you progressed. I remember him showing you how to do, side fades. Then I came in, you start charging a little bit. Then eventually, 2 weeks ago, I brought my brother in. We had a big comedy event in York, Pennsylvania. So I bring my brother in, he's like, I need a cut. And I'm like, whoa, and you were the only one available. And I remember you being in school, just getting out and then getting your license. And my brother has curly hair. He's a pro football player, Omar Brown. He played for the Atlanta Falcons. Kind of, picky. And I'm like, he jumps in your chair. And he jumps in your chair and you say, and I'm like nervous. And you say to me what?
Give me a chance.
Give you a chance. Give you a chance.
I said, give me a chance. I'll prove you wrong.
And we did. I was shaking. I was like this. And you did a particular,
low skin fade.
Low skin fade. And when you came up so fast, and I was just like, because you can take it, you can't put hair back on. You can take it off, but you can't put it back on. So I was in my barber chair, remember? And I went like, whoa, And as a barber, I'm very, I know what to look for. And as the cut came together, it made me feel good because Serge and Alex did a really good job.
Yeah.
The way they prepared you. And my brother, I just told you, he's in Atlanta. He went to the national championship game. And he was like, man, I wish I can get back up there to get a cut from that guy. And I was just like, what? You know what I mean? I was blown away, And he said he can't even get cuts like that in California. So big props to you.
Thank you.
My second barber is who?
Brandon Billing.
Okay, Brandon. And Brandon is, as you can see, I don't know if you can tell, but, your ethnicity is what?
I'm white.
He's white, and he worked in a predominantly Spanish barbershop, so it's kind of crazy. When I went in there, I was just like, I seen all the Dominicans getting their hair cut, all the Dominican barbers, and I looked, and I said, who's the white guy? You know what I mean? And it surprised me. Barbering is a lot less simpler when you cut hair that you understand and like your own type of hair. What happens is you become a master barber when you can start to cut different heads, different types of hair. And how do you feel about working in the predominantly?
I like it because I feel like I'm the underdog. Okay. You know, so it's like you always gotta prove yourself. So I mean, it's always a challenge. You know, I mean, especially with different hair. You know.
Okay. Now, you do a lot of kids. They want parts and stuff and these designs. What's up with that?
Man, they want the craziest things.
Right, yeah.
They will come to you and say, "I want a design." And you always gotta ask the parent because they'll set you up.
Give me something crazy that you had to do.
I've done crosses in kids' heads with the shadow coming off of it.
Nike, Jordan signs.
I try to stay away from them, but okay. You got to be prepared for everything.
What's the easiest money in the barbershop? What's the easiest cut?
All around. Three.
The evens.
All evens.
So he's saying basically you put a clip, a guard, and one left and a little line and bang, and that's...
Yeah.
12 to 15 bucks.
Yeah, and you can get them 15 minutes. As you get good, you can get one of those haircuts out in 15 minutes.
And what's the hardest?
The hardest, I think, skin phase, but it's on the Mexican, the nationality.
Spanish.
Yeah.
They had that real coarse.
It's real thin. It's real straight. You know, they have the pale skin. It's hard.
So the spots, the lining and all that. Okay.
Yeah, it's really hard. I think that's the hardest, but I like doing everything different because it makes you an all-around good barber.
Okay, that's what's up. Now, there's a lot of good barbers in Reading. Give me some of your, you know, barbers that you've, you know, and we're going to exclude ATS and the Academy because we already know that, you know.
Yeah.
But, you know, go elsewhere with it.
Say Brotherly Love.
Brotherly Love?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's my man. Pulling up, right? Yeah, yeah. Pook.
Yep,
that's my man.
Yeah. And Fine Lines.
Okay, Fine Lines. Yeah. Where's that at?
That's in West Reading.
Okay. And what about you?
I like Whiskers Barber Co. My boy Ricky.
Okay.
He was that's out in Chicken Springs. Eric Rodriguez, he got Mike and Joe's barbershop.
Yeah,
they're good. They're good people. It's not all about the barber, and it's what you bring to it.
Right.
You know, that atmosphere, you know, it's just, you know, you gotta be all around good barber.
And then something about a barber, you know, same way when you get your nails done for a woman, their hair done, when a man gets their hair, you know, nice, precise cut, it's a good feeling. It's an air about yourself.
Yeah.
Okay.
Definitely is.
So how long have you been cutting?
A year?
And
yeah, I've been cutting about 2 years.
Okay, so you're on your way.
You're
on your way. And the goal, I guess, is what?
Open my own barbershop.
Open up your own barbershop.
Yeah.
Right. So, get you an ATS.
Yeah.
That's what's up. Eventually teach.
Yeah.
That's what's up. That's what's up. All right. Like I said, I'll be visiting more barbershops, and you know we'll change the occupations up from time to time. But we're a family here on What's Poppin'. So the next group that comes in, you know, everyone needs a haircut. So if I bring someone who does, you know, that repairs stuff and fix stuff, then you know we're gonna all being one, you know, huge conglomerate. We all gonna work together. Dream work is teamwork, and we support each other. So I'm hoping that, you know, the county can get out and go get a haircut and support some of these barbershops that, you know, that are in this area. I'd like to thank you.
Thank you.
I'd like to thank you. And do you have any questions? You know, you have anything you want to say? How can we find you?
You can find me at Facebook, Instagram, Samuel Pomales.
Okay. And you're in there every day?
Yep.
Okay.
9 to 7.
And you're in there?
Yeah, I'm in there 6 days a week. Yep. The only day I take off is Tuesdays, 10 hours a day.
And where can we find you?
You can find me at on Brandon's Cuts on Facebook. Everything's on there.
Okay.
Contact information.
The cut.
If anybody needs a haircut or referral to anybody.
I got a principal. Principal. I met. I went to a Christmas party and met. You know, it was a friend of my woman's. You know, it was her friend and it was her husband, and he's a principal. And I guess they gave him a dare, and he has to like shave something in the back of his head.
Mm-hmm.
I think he's a principal at Ole, So maybe we might conduct that up. You know, yeah. I'm looking for the right barber.
You can always refer them to, you know, if I can't cut you, I'll send you to somewhere where you're. Because at the end of the day, I want to see everybody with a good haircut, whether I do it or not. You know, that's what it's all about.
He's represented. I wish Alex and Serge would, you know, could be here, but they're here, you know, in body. Yeah. You know, not in body, but in spirit. That's what's up. Yeah. Keep up the good work. Yeah. Keep up the good work. Well, there you have a little piece about barbering, and you know, we touched on a couple of different things, and you know, last but not least is for all you youngsters out there, girls, boys, whoever, if you want to learn the art of barbering, it's a heck of a trade, and there's a couple schools around here, and you can contact me, and I'll give you more information. With that said, have a good day, guys. You know, the rest of a good night. I'm going to thank you for coming out. My second guest is someone I have the pleasure of being around every day. But I'm going to pull back from that. You know, we'll pull back from that relationship, and we're going to go to what you've become in my life on a platonic level. And that's a super, super life coach. You know, you've helped me in so many different ways, and I asked you to sit in for the only reason because I know you can help other people. So we can go a number of ways with this, but the first one I want to do is just you introduced yoga to me. When was yoga introduced to you?
I'm Amy, by the way. Nice to see you, Mr.
Yeah, let's
Brown.
Let's back up. You are?
Amy.
Okay.
Yes.
And Amy is, like I said, someone I see every day, all the time. But at the same time, we separate, you know, our relationship from a lot of things we do. We are gym partners. We play tennis. We do yoga. We exercise. And we have really, really long, meaningful conversations to stay on point. And guess what? We're not perfect. I mean, there are sometimes when we are like Bobby and Whitney. and then there's other times when we're like the Partridge Family, you know what I mean?
Like Barack and Michelle.
Yeah, Barack and Michelle, yeah. But what I wanted to highlight was just, you know, give me a little bit about what exercise does for us as humans.
Well, I think that for me, it happened when something terrible happened in my life and I needed to focus and be disciplined. So I found yoga. I practiced Bikram yoga, which is 90 minutes.
Oh, the hot yoga.
Yes.
Yeah, that's where it's almost like you jump into an oven and start exercising. Like the first 2 minutes, you're sweating. It's like you know. Okay, so you said
it's 105 degrees,
and you turn it up sometimes a little more. You know, she goes and just messes with it down, but it's already 105. You know what I mean?
I can tell you, I took him, and he thought it was going to be easy, and it was one of the hardest workouts of his life. And he's an athlete, so it is a phenomenal spiritual, basketball, physical, moving meditation.
Okay. Now, yoga consists of a lot of stretching. You do. Mm-hmm. That thingamajiggy that you do in the front room every day on TV, what's that about?
Oh, I do cardio and weight training?
Yeah, yes. Weight training.
Yes, I do.
And you have your buddies that you heard text back and forth. She's really
Jerry
that.
Love.
Jerry Love.
I follow her, and I'm going to start teaching that too.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So you do like a cardio, and then you do like a
weight fitness. Training. Okay. And then just you and I run together a lot.
Right.
Okay. It definitely is a form of couples counseling.
Couples counseling, no doubt.
To exercise together.
Tell them a little bit about the restart button that we've developed.
Well, I think every couple on days, we get off to a rough start some days. Not every day, but some days. So we have a thing that no matter what either of us said, we reset it, restart it, like it didn't happen. And if you can implement exercise with that, it's amazing.
It's crazy. I'm talking about we could be.
We forget what we're talking about.
Yes, we could be like, and we'd be like, reset, bang, and come back into the concert, into the movies, like.
We're good.
Because really, what, like we're too big to be this small, and I'm hoping that you guys can see that, you know. So, every segment, you know, I'm going to try to do something where we can, you know, enlighten people about, you know, how to snap back, how to stay, you know, mentally, you know, on point.
So I'm willing to try any exercise you send me out to, whether it's the aerial yoga that I've never done,
okay,
cycling, or any of your viewers want me to do, I'll do any workout.
So you got the
for
job.
For the new year.
You got the job. You're working with me now.
Everyone tries to get in shape at the new year, so let's help them.
Okay, that's what's up. Now, what I wanted to do with this show also was to go out and find people who were talented and who maybe had a veil, over it. Like I try to find someone singing on the corner or at the pizza shop, and I found a lot of people that have talents, and we're gonna start this first segment off with a young lady by the name of.
Hi, I'm Brianna.
Okay.
I go by Brianna Shea. I'm 23 years old, and I love to sing.
Okay. And what happened was a friend of mine told me, hey, you got to hear this girl that can really, really sing. And I'm like, hey, everybody can sing. And I was blown away because of I would just pop a name out, and she would sing it. I would pop a name out, and she would sing it. And then when I showed my girl was like, okay, and this is without no coaching. This is without, nobody, even letting her know what, how to even, the vocals, none of that. This is just raw and,
Yeah, a lot of personal training, a lot of personal triumphs.
So we're going to give her a little shot. So give me, give me something by somebody who inspires you or somebody that's hot right now. Give me some Rihanna.
Some Rihanna.
Yeah.
Okay. I guess I'll be singing for you guys Diamonds by Rihanna.
Yeah.
Okay. Shine a light in the beautiful sea. I chose to be happy. You and I, we're like diamonds in the sky. You're a shooting star I see, a vision of ecstasy. When you hold me, I'm alive. We're like diamonds in the sky.
Yes.
Beautiful.
Give me a little bit of Mary. Mary J. Blige.
Mary. Okay, which is crazy because Mary J. Blige is my inspiration, everyone.
Okay.
Baby. There's no need to tell ya, as far as I can think to recall, my love has been here for you, so you don't have to worry at all. I'll sacrifice my time, I'll make sure you're satisfied, and there's no hard things to the joy I bring. Wanna give you all my love, that's all I wanna do.
Yes.
Good job.
And last but not least, we gotta do this for my mom. Give me a little bit of Whitney.
Some Whitney?
Yes, give me some Whitney.
Man.
Give me some Whitney.
You have to set the bar,
Whitney.
All right. Clock strikes upon the hour, and the sun begins to fade. And there's still enough time to figure out how to chase my blues away. All right, I'm gonna stop there
because
I'm a little sick.
I got you. Yeah, she told me she was under the weather.
Yeah, I was a little sick. I'm sure everybody's getting that flu. It's that time,
Well, I appreciate it. I appreciate that
Thank
you came out.
Thank you. I appreciate
out.
You.
And like I said, we got to get you. We going to talk. We might have to get her to a studio.
I wasn't expecting that to come out of her.
I told you.
It was excellent. Thank you.
Thank
you.
Freestyle.
Yeah, it was great.
So I want to appreciate I appreciate from the bottom you guys coming out and supporting this and, helping Berks to see what's popping. And I'm definitely going to invite you guys back. I'm going to be doing this and a lot more types of things like this. So I'm going to get you in where you fit in. So we learned a little bit about barbering. We learned a little bit about the reset and yoga and exercise. And we've seen some talent that's up and coming in the County. So if you got anything that you guys want to let me know about that's popping, call in. If you got some talent, let me know. I'll be on the look. I'm coming. I am coming. Goodbye. God bless and good night.